It's obviously personal opinion. Personally, I think it'll be actually quite evenly split, where I think as we were reaching the end of 2023, it was certainly becoming more a buyer's market, and there was more buyers getting properties much closer to home report valuation, which was really good for them, particularly first-time buyers. I think as we go into 2024, that will remain the case, but what we are seeing, which is good news, is we're seeing some rate reductions from the mortgage lenders, which should mean there's more appetite for more buyers, but with more buyers becomes more competition. And with more competition, you then start to see properties competing with people competing against each other to get those properties, which then can mean prices going back up the way against valuation. So it won't be one size fits all. It'll be a case by case basis, but I think it'll be more a level playing field for both. I think that buyers will still probably get more properties for their money, and we won't be back to like 1-2 years ago where it was much higher, but equally the seller will still do well as well, because I think there will be more buyers out there. This is obviously just, we're only back in week one of 2024, but the positive news is we are seeing mortgage lenders showing a great amount of appetite for lending and competing against each other. And any sort of rate bulletins I'm getting at the moment is rate reductions, and some of the lenders are offering decent rate reductions. So while we'll never get back to the 1s and 2% anytime soon that we had, 12 to 18 months ago, what we are seeing is we're now starting to see rates in the 4s, some on 5-year fixed rates sub 4% for particular loan to values. But that's really positive news, and it shows it's definitely going in the right direction. And it also shows that it's not always directly correlated to the Bank of England base rate, which has remained stable for the last few months as the lenders are doing their own pricing. There's still an abundance of those out there. The criteria is obviously a little bit stricter because you're bringing less of your own money to the table. The interest rate is higher as well, so all these headline rates is not really applicable to these higher loan to values. But the 90 to 95% mortgages have been readily available for a good while now, and that still remains the case. And that obviously can help all types of buyers, particularly first-time buyers who are maybe struggling for the deposit. And when you factor in that they might also not have to pay as much over the valuation for the property, it means that more of their deposit can be used for the mortgage deposit part. So the Bank of England base rates remained stable for the last 2 or 3 months. Everybody's got their own opinion on this, and I don't foresee it changing much over the next month or two, even though we're seeing mortgage rates from lenders go down. But I am hopeful that come spring 2024, we will start to see reductions. How much those reductions are, it's hard to tell, but I'd like to think that the Bank of England base rate will certainly go down potentially 0.75% to 1% during the whole of 2024, which can only be good news for all borrowers.